Dear students, today we will learn about the software. So when you had learned about computers, you must know that there are two things that make a computer, that is a combination of hardware and software. So all the physical components of the computer that you can touch and you can feel make the hardware, and the programs that are loaded on that hardware are called as software. So all the keyboards, mouse, CPU, memory that we can touch, they all come in the category of the hardware. The softwares are the programs that we load on the computer. So what are the programs that we load on the computer? For example, operating system, the Windows, which is loaded on the computer system, or we can load MS Office, or we can load an antivirus software, or we can load a game. All these make a software. The software we can define are a set of programs that control the computer hardware to make them operate. So we can divide software into categories, that is the system software and the application software. So what is the system software? System software consists of the operating system. What is the operating system? Operating system is the main program, for example Windows, which runs your computer. Without an operating system, your computer hardware is lifeless. So whenever we have a computer, we need to install an operating system such as Windows or maybe a Linux. Or if you have a mobile phone, you are using a mobile phone, it is also a type of a small computer. You have to use an operating system, and you may be using an Android or you may be using an iOS if you are using an Apple mobile phone. So a system software is a software which controls the activities of the hardware, such as when you give command, then that command, how it is processed, how it will be displayed on the monitor. So there are many operations which are performed by the system software, and most of them concerned with the management of the software programs which are installed on your computer system. So one of the best examples of a system software is Windows operating system that is installed on most of the computers and laptops that we use. The other type of software is the application software. The application software are the programs which are developed for a particular purpose. For example, you need or you use a word processor such as Word for typing a document, for writing letters, applications, or you can use Excel for doing calculations, storing data in the form of rows and columns and doing multiplication and doing all calculations you have done. So an application software is software which is developed for a particular purpose. So the Word, Excel, PowerPoint, or the games that you play, or antivirus software, they all come into the category of the application software. The application software, if we categorize them, they come into the category of payroll system, inventory, spreadsheets, desktop publishing, or you are using Adobe Photoshop for editing photos. Then all these softwares, they come into the category of the application software. So now, as I have told you, there is a relationship between the hardware and software. So without software, the hardware could not work, and without hardware, the software could not work. So a computer is a combination of the hardware and software. So we need to have the hardware components as well as we need to have software installed on them. For example, if we have a computer system with us, then we must install an operating system, that is Windows 9, Windows 10 or Windows 7 or whatever we are using. We should use that operating system, and that operating system basically gives command to the hardware, for example a printer, to print something, to monitor, to display something, or to a scanner, to scan something, or to the CD or the DVD writer or player to play a DVD or CD. So the operating system manages the memory of your computer. So Hardware and software, they work in combination with one another. Both are required to make a complete computer system. So now let's come to the next topic, that is the data system. Data system means that how the data is stored in your computer. So as we all know, the data is very important, and we use the computers to store data so that we can save the data and we can see it, we can refer to it later. So data in a computer is stored in the form of bits and bytes. So you will ask, what is a bit? So a bit is a character, because computer only understands one language, that is the machine language or the binary language. And the binary language is made up of only two characters, 0 and 1. So a bit is either a 0 or 1. And these are called as binary digits. When 8 binary digits are combined together, they make a byte. And 8 bits together make a byte, and which is equal to a single character. So these bits are a combination of a particular type of coding, which is called as SPASCII, which stands for American Standard Code for Information Interchange, which means that 8 combinations of 0s and 1s make a character or make a byte. Okay, so now we come to the next topic, that is, what is a field? So whenever storing the data, we store the data in the form of rows and columns. The columns are called as fields. For example, a table you make in which you store your admission number, you store your name, you store your class, you store your section. So the field is the column name. For example, roll number, name, admission number, they are all the examples of a field. Then if column is a field, then a row is a record. So for example, if we say the admission number of a person is 1234 and the name is Aman and class is 9th and section is A, then this whole row of data of that particular person makes a record. So each single row represents a record in a table. It could be name, it could be friend's phone number, it could be address, it could be date of birth, it could be name, it could be roll number, it could be anything. So a table is a combination of rows and columns, means the table is a combination of fields and records. A field is a column and a record is a row. Now let's see, what is a file? A file is the collection of records, collection of data combined together. When we collect the record together, it makes a file. So now, what is a database? A database is a collection of many files. It may contain many files containing different type of data. So for example, a database of a bank contains the information about the clients or the people who have their account in that particular bank, all the information about them. Or a school may have the information about of all the students standing in that school, all the employees which are working in that particular school. So a database is a large collection of data, different type of data, and which is stored in many files. So now please write some questions regarding whatever we have learned. The first question is, what is software? The second is, what is the difference between a system software and application software? And third is, what is the difference between field and a record? So kindly do these questions in your copies, note them down. Thank you.